Yo, kids, here's a Flamin' Hot Cheeto Snacks. Deliciously hot, dangerously cheesy.
Richard Montañez is well known as the man who claims to have invented Flamin' Hot Cheetos. Having dropped out of the fourth grade, he could barely read or write, and at the age of 18, he began working as a janitor. But soon enough, things began to change. And eventually, a Flamin' Hot legacy was born. Although he didn't go to college or even completed high school, that never stopped Richard from building his own empire. In fact, he believes his success comes precisely from his struggles. And when someone asked him whether he has a PhD, he said the following.
I have a PhD. I've been poor, hungry, and determined. And I think when you've experienced those three things, there's a lot of wisdom.
Curious to find out how Richard Montañez made it happen? And whether he is even the true inventor of these tasty hot chips? Then keep watching. Richard Montañez was born in Mexico in 1958. Later, his family migrated to the US and settled in Guasti, a small town close to the state of California. His family was poor, and they lived in a farm workers' camp. And together with his parents and 10 siblings, Richard lived in a one-bedroom apartment. Privacy didn't exist. As a child, Richard had no idea that he was poor. "No one ever taught me what was on the other side of the tracks," he once said in an interview. On Richard's side of the tracks, ambition wasn't high. Most kids he knew hoped to get a job at the town's factory. And as both his grandfather and father made a living picking grapes, Richard naturally ended up doing the same too. Every little bit mattered, and throughout his childhood, little Richard worked hard to help his family out. As you can guess, living in a one-bedroom apartment with 13 people isn't easy. But what particularly stood out to Richard was the fact that his whole childhood revolved around leftovers and donations. The family owned very little, and whatever they did own was often worn out and old. To make matters worse, school wasn't easy either. In his memoir, A Boy, A Burrito, and A Cookie, he writes about his first day of third grade. His mom had sent him to school with a burrito for lunch, and Richard remembered how embarrassed he felt. It was the 1960s, and back then, very few people had seen a burrito, he writes. "There I was with this burrito and everyone staring at me. I put it back in my bag and hid it." He never ate the burrito and returned home hungry that day. He didn't want to stand out, and he asked his mom to make him a bologna sandwich like the other kids. But instead, she packed him another burrito and added another one to it. One for Richard and one to give to a friend. His friend loved it too, and soon enough, other classmates began requesting one as well. By the end of the week, his mom's burritos were so popular that the 7-year-old entrepreneur began selling them for 25 cents each. But while little Richard managed to make a few good friends, he still wrestled with the school system. As a native Spanish speaker with no language resources, he struggled to understand his teachers. "I remember my mom getting me ready for school, and I was crying. I couldn't speak English." After failing to pick up on basic reading and writing, he eventually dropped out entirely. Without a diploma, he was forced to take up a series of low-paying jobs, like killing chickens, picking weeds, and washing cars. At the time, Richard was 18 years old. He was exhausted and saw no end to his life in poverty. But then, a friend told him about a janitor opening at a nearby Frito-Lay plant. The salary they offered was more than what Richard was making at the time, $4 an hour. And besides a better salary, they also offered insurance and benefits. Richard saw an opportunity, and he immediately filled in an application. Of course, seeing that he couldn't read or write, a friend of his had to do the filling out for him. Richard returned the application later that day, and he was hired on the spot. Richard was elated that he had landed the job. But when he shared the news with his family, his grandfather imparted a piece of wisdom that would stick with him forever. "Make sure that the floor shines, and let them know that a Montañez mopped it." Following his grandfather's advice, Richard quickly made an impact. He always made sure that all the rooms he cleaned were as tidy as can be, And aside from his janitorial duties, he also began learning about the company and its products by watching how the machines operated. Nonetheless, Richard still came from humble beginnings and his ambitions were modest. His big dream was to someday drive Frito-Lay's trash truck. But once he finally learned that he could have even bigger dreams, that all changed. One day, the president of the company, Roger Enrico, sent a video message to his employees. He wanted to boost morale, and he encouraged every worker to act like an owner. Richard looked around him. He didn't see much of a reaction from his colleagues, but the message had a big impact on him, and he saw it as a perfect opportunity to finally do something different. By now, he had been mopping floors for nearly a decade, and he felt ready for something new. Little did he know, his big opportunity would come sooner than expected. After a machine broke down in the assembly line, some Cheetos didn't get dusted with the usual bright orange cheese powder. The plain Cheetos could not be sold, so Richard took a couple of batches home with him. He pimped them up by putting some chili powder on them, and by doing so, he basically created his own recipe for a spicier version of Cheetos. Inspiration always comes from somewhere, and in this case, Richard had been inspired by a street vendor in his neighborhood who made Mexican grilled corn with lime and chili, aka elote. I see the corn man adding butter, cheese, and chili to the corn, and thought, what if I add chili to a Cheeto? He explained. He shared the snack with his friends and family, and they all loved it. Richard was happy with his successful experiment, but the next day, he began to notice something. He saw no food products catering to Latinos. It was then that he decided it was time to act as an owner. Amazed by the delicious creation, his family and friends encouraged him to tell the plant supervisors about it, but Richard wanted to take it a step further. He wanted to talk to Roger, the CEO. After all, it was he who had sent out a video asking all employees to take ownership of the company. Not knowing you weren't supposed to call the CEO yourself, he rang him up. But of course, Roger's assistant picked up instead. She asked him his name and where he worked, and he told her his name was Richard Montañez and that he worked as a janitor in the Rancho Cucamonga plant. While the assistant was obviously surprised, she said she'd put him through, and a couple of seconds later, Richard was talking to the CEO. Talking about this unusual moment, he said the following. The assistant was a visionary for even putting me through to Roger. He got on the line and said, "Hi Richard, I hear you've got an idea." He told me he would be down at the plant in 2 weeks and that he wanted to hear my idea. Richard was delighted that the CEO was interested, but the next day at work, he realized he might have gotten himself into something big. Roger had been impressed by Richard's idea, so he had called several other upper managers of the corporation, including the division president, the vice president, and the plant manager at the Rancho Cucamonga plant. But when this last one received the call, he wasn't so excited. He immediately tracked Richard down at work and called him into his office. Once Richard closed the door, the manager began yelling at him. "Who do you think you are? Do you realize what you've done? Everybody will be coming here." The man then took a second to catch his breath and said to Richard, "You're doing a presentation." At that moment, Richard thought to himself, "Who do I think I am? What right do I have to call the CEO?" In school, he never did his homework. And now he was going to give a presentation to the company executives in just 2 weeks' time? And he didn't even own a tie. How hopeless the situation may have seemed, Richard felt motivated, and he wasn't going to let anything get in his way. He rushed out to buy a tie and picked up a book on marketing from the public library. And he also designed unique plastic bags to package his spicy Cheetos. Finally, the big day came. Richard gathered his handmade product and went to the meeting. Around his neck was a $3 tie that his neighbor had tied for him. He promoted the spicy flavor as appealing to the growing Latino market, and the executives were immediately amazed at his product design. That day, Flamin' Hot Cheetos was born. The managers were willing to give it a go. 6 months later, Flamin' Hot Cheetos was soft launched to a test market in Los Angeles, and it immediately became a massive success. People loved it, and especially the Latino community was a big fan. Richard's chips did so well that they were eventually approved for national release in 1992. The spicy flavor rejuvenated Frito-Lay, and the brand garnered billions in revenue. With his new invention, Richard's career finally began taking off too. But while his product was a success, he also realized he had a long way ahead. Terms such as market share, return on investment, and profit margin were still all foreign to him. Nonetheless, over the years, he managed to climb his way up the corporate ladder, and he eventually landed an executive job with PepsiCo. But despite the hotshot position and impressive salary, he always wanted to continue motivating others too. And he has held countless motivational speeches in which he shares his unusual rags-to-riches tale. It didn't take long before his story went viral, and in 2018, Fox Searchlight Pictures signed on to produce a biopic about him called Flamin' Hot. Screenwriter Lewis Pollack penned the script, and none other than Eva Longoria and Devon Franklin will direct and produce it. The film is still to be released, but it's safe to say that by now, Richard is a star. People love his story and they feel like they can identify with him. And for many in and around Los Angeles, Richard was a folk icon. So when in May 2021, LA Times published a 5,000-word article titled "The Man Who Didn't Invent Flamin' Hot Cheetos," people were shocked, to say the least. Richard included. In the article, the LA Times stated that it had found discrepancies in Richard's story. According to them, his timeline didn't add up. And to make matters worse, his former employer, Frito-Lay, also said that the facts do not support the urban legend. According to Frito-Lay, there was no evidence to support Richard's claims that he invented Flamin' Hot Cheetos. And they stated that none of their records showed that Richard was involved in the Flamin' Hot test market. As you can guess, the article caused an uproar. Feuds like these about who's the real inventor or CEO aren't uncommon. And if you've watched our video on Tesla, you'll know exactly what we're talking about. Some fans were upset with Richard for having lied for so long, while others were upset with the LA Times for what they perceived as a tearing down of a successful Latino businessman. Richard himself has since also stepped forward to voice his discontent. And Frito-Lay even went as far as to backtrack some of its previous comments with an official statement. In it, they describe Richard as invaluable to the company and the Flamin' Hot Cheetos product, but they don't go as far as confirming his version of the snack's origins. This was the story of Richard Montañez. And while he didn't attain a high school diploma, he still managed to work himself up in a rather unusual way. After mopping floors for over a decade, his boss encouraged him to act like an owner. And soon enough, he spotted a hole in the market and catered to it with his spicy snack. Today, the spicy version of the classic chips is one of Frito-Lay's most popular products, and it has evolved into a cultural phenomenon. And people all over the world love the chips and the rad tiger that promotes them. Had you already heard of Richard's story? And who do you think is the real inventor of Flamin' Hot Cheetos? Share your opinion in the comments. I'd love to hear what you think. And if you enjoyed this video, don't forget to check out our channel for more inspiring business videos.